Tonight on Dateline. It's a family feud over housework Dateline's been following for 5 years.
I just cleaned this and you come in here like a slob and you mess it up.
Sound familiar? She's ready to explode.
Thank you for leaving me with this, Victor.
It's threatened their marriage.
You do nothing.
Mm-hmm. Now it's time to get tough.
The queen of clean to meet the king of clutter.
Can this master organizer turn a pack rat husband into a lean, mean cleaning machine?
He'll make mincemeat out of her in 10 seconds. It's
been a year. Rob Stafford with the latest on Chore Wars. From our studios in New York, here is Stone Phillips.
Good evening. She works hard around the house. He works hard at avoiding work around the house. Sound familiar? The battle over housework. Chances are you've engaged in one or two skirmishes yourself. But the couple you're about to meet has raised the chore wars to an art form. And we should know, we've been following them for years. But this time around, Dateline did more than observe. As Rob Stafford tells us, we brought in reinforcements.
I just cleaned this and you come in here like a slob and you mess it up. How come I have to clean up after everybody else's breakfast? Thank you for leaving me with this, Victor.
It's been 5 years since Dateline first visited the Raison family from Long Island. And it seems not much has changed.
Hallie?
Come on.
Room. Clean up your room, Hallie.
A minute.
Not in a minute. Now.
Back then, Lisa Raison complained she was always cleaning up after her family, with no help from her husband, Victor.
I'm stuffed.
I asked you to clean the table off.
I am. I will. I didn't have a chance to yet.
And Victor complained his wife was often on his case.
Is Lisa unfair?
At times, she could be unfair. Sometimes I just have really busy, rough days. I come home, it's 6:30, 7 o'clock, I'm exhausted.
What do you want from Mario?
Let's go back to the fall of 1998. The Raisons, like many couples, are fighting about housework. They say their fights have even threatened their marriage. Lisa once got so mad at Victor, she wanted to throw him out right along with all his clutter.
I would just take like his clothes that he hadn't cleaned up and I would open the front door and I would just right out the front door.
I came home and my entire office was in a dumpster. And I had to get my brother-in-law to come help me and hold my feet as I went into a dumpster to retrieve work.
In hopes of ending their war over chores, the Raisons agreed to let Dateline come into their lives, to set up hidden cameras in their home, and then to show our video to an expert who'd offer advice on how to solve their housework woes and mend their relationship.
Do you have, like, hemorrhoids today that you can't get up?
Before you start taking sides, there's a few things you should know about the Raisons. At the time these videos are taken, Victor is a sales consultant who works long hours and makes a healthy income. Lisa's a stay-at-home mom who cooks, cleans, and takes care of their two children, aged 5 and 10. She has help from a cleaning woman once a week, but says Victor is hardly any help at all. And Lisa would be the first to tell you, she hassles her husband all the time. Can you be tough on him?
Yeah.
Do you appreciate what he does?
Yes, I appreciate what he does. He's a hard worker. He's a good husband. He tries to be a good father.
But there are some things about Victor Lisa does not appreciate. She gave us a tour of chores her husband either hasn't done or has done badly.
You can see the clip is empty. I'm still waiting for him to get the piece.
Does he help out in the kitchen?
Well, he empties the dishwasher, but right now it's full, so there's dishes waiting to go in. He cooks sometimes for himself. He makes eggs and bacon, and he'll make this whole big to-do with the eggs and the bacon, and then, like, he'll take the egg and he'll crack it here and he'll walk it across to the garbage, so it's like dripping egg all the way on the way, and then he'll make the bacon and it's splattered to death all over, and then he sits down and he eats it, and he'll throw it all in the sink, and that's it.
Sometimes Lisa says Victor does empty the garbage, but when he doesn't, he's full of excuses.
These are my favorites. It's raining, it's snowing, it was cold, I forgot.
As for home repairs, forget about it. She says Victor walks past this broken stone in the doorway every day. The stone is called a saddle.
He broke this?
Yes.
And how long has it been like this?
3 years.
3 years?
Yes.
Have you asked him to fix
it? Yes. Almost every day of my life.
And what does he say?
I will. I got to get the piece.
Is there any way to get Victor to do more housework or get Lisa to turn down the volume?
No. Okay, Victor, I heard you. What
they need to work as a team, then most people are just not working as a team when it comes to housework and other issues.
Dr. Howard Markman is a research psychologist at the University of Denver who studies couples like this and runs workshops. He's found that after money and children, housework is the number three cause of fights among couples. And he's written a book, Fighting for Your Marriage.
Things just kind of build up and build up and build up, and resentments build up and hostilities build up. So these little events that happen daily trigger a lot of emotional resentment that erupt.
Dr. Markman says the biggest mistake most men make is taking their partners for granted. Over time, wives get angry over all the work they do that goes unnoticed. And the more they complain, the more men like Victor withdraw. Dr. Markman saw this happening again and again when he sat down with the Raisons and watched our tape.
I'm bored to death. I can't stay here like this. I'm bored to death.
You're always bored to death on the weekend. And then you complain during the week that you do too much.
Oh, shut up, Victor. I do too much cleaning, possibly. I do too much work, possibly. Maybe it would be nice just to do something other than physical labor. But you do nothing.
Mm-hmm. I think that's one of the things that Lisa really wants to see changed in your relationship, even more than the housework, is just kind of getting your attention and having you communicate to her that you really care about her and love her, and vice versa. But sometimes we don't communicate to the people we love the most that we treasure and honor them.
Okay.
And what about Lisa? What can she do to change?
Your job is to realize that talking about your negative feelings at the time you're feeling them is not a good idea.
Right.
Take some deep breaths. And the two of you need to find another time to talk about these issues when the kids aren't around.
Dr. Markman came up with a peace plan for the Raisons, a list of obligations for Victor and Lisa. They should meet once a week to air their feelings and argue about housework only at this time. Lisa should reduce the size of her chore list to just 3 items a weekend. And Victor would agree to complete at least one of those jobs each week.
Victor, are you willing to try this?
Yes, I am. It's worth a shot. I mean, I think I can try and do some more things around the house that I do not do.
So the Raisons agreed to call a temporary truce in their war over chores. For 2 months, Lisa tried to complain less, and Victor tried to help out more. And when we stopped by for a progress report, there was a definite difference.
I'm a little happier.
Is Lisa less angry? No, she's just controlled. Are we fighting less? I think a little bit.
Yes.
And how much progress has Victor made in 2 months?
He fixed the blinds that were broken.
And I cleaned it, threw out the boxes, some of the boxes in the garage that I would junk.
Yeah. Yep, he did do that.
The mood of the house seemed to have improved. Lisa wasn't yelling in front of the kids as much and not hassling Victor all the time.
So if you go up and you make your bunk like your own room,
and if I go up.
Dr. Markman says the Raisons are on the right track, but that was after 2 months. A year and a half ago, 3 years after our first visit, the Raisons invited us back for an update.
Well, hello.
Hi. How you doing? Before we go inside, keep in mind some things have changed since the last time we were here. Lisa now has a part-time job and no longer has help from a cleaning lady. As for Victor, he's working longer hours than ever before. In the last 3 years, do you think you've been able to follow through on the peace plan that you came up with?
I have a hard time remembering what that plan was.
So the answer is what?
A resounding no.
And as Lisa gave us a tour of the house, it was clear the peace plan was a distant memory, at least for Victor.
Okay. He's had 3 years to clean this garage.
Right. Here I come. My pride and my joy, the garage.
How many times since I last talked to you do you think you've asked Victor to clean the garage?
36. Once a month for 3 years.
Once a month?
Yeah.
And he says?
I will, this Saturday. And then Saturday comes and goes. It's either too hot, too cold, it's raining, it's snowing. Not unlike the garbage. Right. It's a weather condition, yeah.
In a minute?
In a minute, yeah.
But you still have a sense of humor about it.
Oh, it's, well, you know, I'd be dead if I didn't.
And what about that infamous saddle, the piece of broken stone in the doorway?
Look at that. It's in three. Look at all the dust that collects under this broken stone.
This is actually, I think, worse than it was last time.
Well, now it's totally separated. Now it has these ugly tape marks and crazy glue that didn't work.
And last time I was here, it had been broken for 3 years.
Yeah, 6 years.
I took the tour of the house, Victor.
Oh, okay.
The saddle.
My famous saddle.
I mean, you walk over that thing every day.
Yes, I do.
And it still doesn't bother you?
No, it's almost like my memento.
Why not just pick up the phone and call someone in to do it?
I could. I mean, I figured she would have done that by now.
No, that'll be here until our children have children.
Victor admits he hasn't changed, but says his wife has.
I think she's complaining a little less, yes.
Yelling less?
At times less, yes.
Not as angry as before?
Probably not as angry as before, too.
Lisa's got a part-time job. She doesn't have the housekeeper. So she's doing more than she was doing 3 years ago. And when you look around the house... And I want to stick up for you, man, but
it's getting hot, isn't it?
It's tough to stick up for me now.
I'll be the gracious one, and I'll tell you that he's much, much busier at work.
But what if Victor had more time? What if he had another year and a half to clean the garage? Surely he could carve an hour a week out of his busy schedule to complete the number one item on Lisa's honey-do list.
Do we need the drum roll?
Yes,
all right, let's see.
When we come back, we return to the Raisons one more time for another inspection. The moment of truth for Victor. And this time, there will be consequences.
Has the pack rat been transformed? Is the garage gorgeous? And what's ahead if it isn't?
Time for the heavy artillery.
Heavy artillery.
Is Victor ready for the Queen of Clean? They've been feuding over housework. Now a pack rat husband has promised to clear out the clutter. But did he come clean? The moment of truth when Dateline continues. From our studios in New York, here again is Stone Phillips.
Is there any way this couple can end their war over housework? They've been given one more chance. Get it right, or Dateline brings in the big guns. Once again, Rob Stafford.
It's been a year and a half since our last visit to the Raisons, and we're back to see what kind of progress they've made getting organized and cleaning up the clutter in their house. We're back. How are you doing, Lisa?
Hi, how are you? Long time no see.
Victor?
Oh, Rob, good to see you.
The nightmare's return.
Here we go again.
First stop, the garage. The moment of truth for Victor. Had he squandered the year and a half extension on his assignments, or had he buckled down and found the time to clean the garage?
Victor, you look a little nervous.
Moment of truth.
Yikes.
I think we have a challenge today.
I think some of this stuff is in the exact same spot it was last
time. That definitely is. That's the air conditioner I wanted to put in the house because it's 89 degrees today.
What happened to the plan, man?
Well, you know, the house looks good inside. Kitchen's been redone.
In fact, the Raisons did hire a contractor to resolve one of Lisa's other pet peeves. The infamous broken saddle in the kitchen doorway that had been the source of so many fights.
And it's fixed.
It's all new. New and improved.
So Victor gets an A for this.
No, he does not.
Why not?
Because he didn't do it.
Even though he didn't do the work, he does get credit for footing the bill. And the Raisons didn't stop there. They had the entire kitchen redone. Lisa says the trouble is Victor was supposed to clean out the cupboards before the carpenters started the job.
Victor, before we start. Before we start, can you put the laundry baskets away?
Yeah.
Take a look at the video our photographer shot during the process. Not exactly a strong start for Victor. It looks like business as usual. And Lisa remains the general, barking out orders.
Lay it there. Don't put the dog food in there. I don't want the dog food with the people food. Come on, Victor, start thinking. You don't put glue in with the medicine. And you don't have to put this in here. I said the medication.
Okay. What's that thing?
That's Epicat. In case I poison you, you might want to save yourself your vomit.
Oh, that's a cyanide poisoning, yeah. I'm waiting for that day.
I want to get rid of this girl. Zoe!
You gonna throw that out?
Yeah, I don't want it. It's old.
Oh, okay.
I just need a box.
I don't think I have one.
Is that so much to ask?
Actually, it is, because getting to the basement where the boxes are kept proves to be a dangerous journey.
Okay, the obstacle course. I tripped over something in the basement.
But we digress. Let's get back to the garage. Victor was supposed to have cleaned it over the 18 months since our last visit.
How do you get to the refrigerator to get food?
From the other door,
which you
have to step over the chair.
You know what's a real challenge? When you want to come out and get water.
Look, if you need something, it's easy. Rob, look, you make a right foot here, left foot here. Step on this carton, okay? Hold on to the bike, swing around. Once you pop the poppy paper, you know you're close to the refrigerator.
You gotta memorize those steps.
This is unbelievable.
It's a challenge.
Why do you save that?
Why do you save the boxes?
Well, we didn't know. We had a 90-day warranty and they needed the box. So we just got the TV a couple months ago, so I hung on to it.
So there's a story
for everything in here.
And just about everything you can think of is in here.
That's where the menorah is.
The menorah box.
I wanted to know I couldn't find it.
Just in case you want to celebrate Hanukkah in the garage.
Why you sleep
it out the window?
Why you sleep it out?
And another menorah. You got everything.
That's great. She just buys them because she can't find them.
This lamp.
Yeah, that was moved from...
Well, sometimes you need light when you come in to read.
And I guess if you want to clean up... Supplies are here.
Readily accessible antibacterial, too.
How many years? 7 years? 8 years?
8 years.
8 years.
Yeah.
2 national television appearances. Where the world saw this.
Right, and still.
And he told me he'd do it.
He fibbed. F minus.
Finally, even we were fed up. Something needed to be done. So with the Raison's consent, Dateline decided to conduct what you could describe as an intervention.
The plan for you guys was to work as a team as you tackle this project. We have brought the Queen of Clean to meet the King of Clutter.
Let me tell you something. She'll make mincemeat out of her in 10 seconds.
Right. Well, don't be so sure. Meet Henny Lambright. She heads a company called Clutter Cleaners. She calls herself a clutterologist.
A specialist in clutter. We will purge out the things that we don't need.
After watching the Raison story and seeing what a pack rat Victor was, Henny wrote to Dateline and offered her services to Victor and Lisa pro bono. Her assistant, Mary Dawson, came along to help.
So the goal is to have a car in the garage?
Something the Raisons haven't been able to do in years.
Let's go.
Okay. Let's go.
Penny has a simple 3-step strategy for anyone trying to conquer the clutter in their lives. First, remove everything.
Take everything out.
Absolutely.
Second, divide your belongings into 3 categories. Throw, save, donate to charity.
I'll donate that.
Divide and conquer.
Penny says anything you haven't used in more than a year should probably go.
We can get rid of that lamp, Lisa.
Step number 3.
Dive in and just start. Have a lot of water on hand.
And in the Raison's case, a really big trash can.
So time for the heavy artillery.
Heavy artillery.
You think you're going to fill that dumpster by the time the day is over?
I think it'll be more than full.
So Victor has his work cut out for him. But within 15 minutes, an extraordinary transformation seems to begin. Victor takes to the task with enthusiasm. Right away, he's pitching in and throwing out.
Garbage. Motor, drapery motor, need that.
Okay. Yes, no, maybe?
No, it's broken.
Lisa helps, but it looks like Victor's really doing most of the work.
Everything in that bag, we can throw out. It's all stuffed animals, it can go.
How would you feel if Lisa were supervising this project today?
I wouldn't be involved.
Obviously, that's the answer. It's Penny who's in charge, not Lisa.
Where's the stuff that you're donating? Right here.
His wife has been asking him to do that for 8 years.
Yes.
Why are you able to do it so quickly?
I'm not family. and I'm not attached to the stuff.
We all love Victor, but I know as you start taking stuff out, he's going to start putting it back in.
No. I have confidence, and I know I can work with him.
No, believe me. He will start putting stuff back in.
In fact, watch what happens here.
Filters. I threw out my filters. I need these. You never know when you need them.
There is no logic in Victor world.
Oh, great. You'll be a director.
Say payback.
To the moon, Alice.
Penny knows you can't reason with a 200-pound pack rat, but you can use some psychology to manipulate it.
Keep Victor, in this case, focused on what we're doing.
This is all garbage back here where I'm going.
Giving him a game plan of going through things and just keep checking on him.
And some positive reinforcement seems to keep Victor going.
Victor, 30 minutes in, show me the progress.
30 minutes in? I think
there's
we made good headway, Rob.
There's a floor.
There's actually a floor.
A place to put shelving and clear plastic containers the Raisons will buy to store the stuff they decide to keep.
Feels great. Love it. 95 degrees and sweating. Maybe I'll lose weight.
So you're working hard out there. But what's going through your mind?
Hope I don't have a heart attack. 95 degrees.
I don't feel well.
Penny says this is actually the best time. When people are tired and disgusted, they tend to throw out more of the things they don't really need.
All in a day's work.
This is the fun part.
Victor's sweating. He's got this look in his eye. And to you, do you have him in the palm of your hand right now?
Almost. He's visualizing the car in the garage. He's seeing it. He's seen what we're doing with the shelving going in.
He's willing to throw out things he thought he could never part with.
Yes. What he thought he needed this morning is not what he needs now. He's now looking at that pile going, that's not going back in there, the car is.
But as the afternoon sun bears down, tempers begin to heat up.
I'm throwing out garbage, Victor. It's garbage. It's time to start getting rid of it.
What are you throwing out?
It's garbage.
How do you know it's garbage?
What are you following me? It's garbage.
Okay.
Newspapers. That's garbage.
No,
you took it out of your car.
No, I didn't.
Dump.
I need these. Will you stop it?
You know what? I'm done.
Good. But it's a bluff. Lisa stays.
People are going to start pulling up and asking if we're having a yard sale.
And in fact, they do.
This is a garage sale, right?
No.
Oh, it's not a garage sale.
No, no. But if maybe later.
You could have pulled me.
Proving once again that one man's trash is another man's treasure.
You want that?
Oh, this? No, we don't use this anymore. You need it?
Thank you very much. I got plenty of bugs around the pool.
Okay, cool. Thank you.
Thank you.
Come back tonight. You can go through the dumpster. It'll be here.
We never do garage sales.
We're
not for profit.
They get rid of the ugly lamp and then find something really vital.
This is my will.
I know.
What's it doing in here?
I found it in the garage. I put it on the side.
What was it doing in here?
It was on the shelf.
We found our will. I'll ask Will in testament.
And looking at Victor's accelerated heart rate, that could have been a fortunate thing.
Heads up, heads up.
I was sweating and I was pink. I'm sure I looked pink.
At least you found the will in case something happened.
Thank God.
But Victor would survive to see something he never thought he'd see. The back wall of his garage. 7 hours, one dumpster, and a lot of sweat later, the moment the Raisons had been waiting for.
1996, my red Jeep was the last car to pull this garage. That was the last time.
But a few minutes later, listen to daughter Hallie.
Give him like a few weeks to be like trashy again.
Victor vows to keep it clean, but what about the basement? Well, he's not ready to go there yet. It's a place where Victor's found a spot for just about everything, but he'd rather our cameras stay out.
You cannot allow it in here. You're not allowed in my basement.
Until next time, America.
It's been fun. See ya.
Bye.
Y'all come back now here.
So how's the new program going? Well, we're told the last time the car saw the inside of the garage was August. Lisa says that while the garage is no longer life-threatening, it is once again a mess, thanks to the VCR, the computer, and the treadmill that got dumped there after all that new space became available. But there is hope. Lisa says the garage is still not as bad as the basement. For more tips from our clutter buster, visit our website at dateline.msnbc.com.